On the eve of June 6, 1944, Richard Scott Brown, a member of the Royal Air Force 644 Squadron from Port Arthur, Ontario, was towing gliders out under the moonlight. Just after midnight, he would seize bridges in enemy territory. Securing these access points proved to be critical to the success of Operation Neptune. It meant that the infantry could send over heavy artillery on the morning of D-Day and help the men who had carried out the amphibious landings. Norman Harold Kirby, a Bren gunner from British Columbia, was one of these men. A member of the North Shore Infantry Regiment, he stormed Juno Beach on the morning of June 6, 1944. But while making its way to shore, the landing craft carrying his unit hit a mine. So Norman Kirby did what he had been trained to do. He ran. Without any weapons save a knife, a fork, and a spoon, Norman Kirby ran across the beach towards the enemy. He would go on to fight in Belgium, Germany, and Holland. He was just 19 years old. Come, Normand Kirby.
Norman Kirby.
Comme Normand Kirby.
Norman Kirby.
Jean Trump.
Jean Trump.
Just
19 years old on D-Day. Originary from Montreal. And also, he was far from home. He went to the shore under the rain of bombardments. He remembers of the carnage that he was witness that day. The screams of his comrades that were injured, the bombs, bodies lifeless all over the shore, bodies of his friends, the soldier and the lieutenant and even the captain, where Jean Trump will say later that he saw the worst and the best of human being in the world and Second World War.
14,000 Canadians stormed Juno Beach that day with no guarantee of victory. It was a gamble like the world had never seen before. But when duty called, Canadians from coast to coast to coast answered. The 3rd Division and the 2nd Armored Brigade represented all of Canada. They were comprised of men like Richard Scott Brown, Norman Harold Kirby, and Jean Trump, men who came from different parts of our great country to serve. On the battlefields of Normandy, Francophones, Anglophones, Indigenous peoples, new Canadians came together as one. One fighting force standing on guard for their British, American, and French allies. One country standing on guard for the wounded soldier, the imprisoned brother, the oppressed sister, the grieving mother, the deceased father. Standing on guard for democracy, for liberty, for peace.
The Canadian troops have succeeded to go further in enemy territory than anybody else in the D-Day. Our soldiers just entered history, and that night they will cry the loss of all the ones they'll never see again. The loss of fathers, brothers, 75 years ago. day for day. They made the sacrifice of their lives for their compatriots, for future generations, for you and me. More than 5,000 Canadians fell in the battlefields of Normandy. 75 years later, we remember. We remember how big their sacrifice was. We remember the ones that were in the first wave that had heavy losses in the first hours of the D-Day. We remember their courage, their tenacity, their generosity.
We thank them not only for their sacrifice, but for their example, for inspiring countless young men and women to answer the call of duty like they once did, for teaching us the value of service, for showing us the true meaning of honor. We thank them for leaving us a better world than the one they once inherited. We owe an enormous debt of gratitude to the men who fought the beaches of Normandy. Grâce à eux, nous vivons,
we live
dans la liberté,
in freedom,
dans la paix.
In peace.
Grâce à eux,
because
les valeurs
of them,
de paix et de
the values of peace, democracy, are defining our country.
Mais l'héritage qu'ils nous ont légué,
the heritage they leg to us is even greater than our frontiers.
Ils ont façonné le monde
they
dans lequel nous
shaped
vivons.
The world in
ils
which we live. They really made all those friendship links with so many countries today. They inspired great powers that are managing diplomacy,
la Banque mondiale, et j'en passe.
NATO.
Grâce à eux, grâce
because
aux
of them,
qu'ils
because
ont
of their sacrifice that they knew how to do 75 years ago,
monde,
our world
sûr,
is safer,
connecté,
is more connected,
et plus pacifique
and more
qu'il
peaceful than it was back then.
I stand here knowing that I can never fully understand what our brave men and women in uniform experienced and will never forget. Only those who threw themselves against the walls of the fortress of Europe in Normandy know the full extent of what unfolded here 75 years ago. But it is the responsibility of all Canadians to ensure that their story and their sacrifice will never be forgotten. It is up to us to preserve and protect the values for which they fought, up to us to uphold their proud legacy, and we will not let them down. Merci.
Thank you.